You are signed in as Casey, who has the preparer role in the Enterprise Journal's approval workflow. From the homepage, you can access Enterprise Journal's tasks assigned to you by clicking Open to navigate to the worklist. Here, you can display all Enterprise Journal's tasks that you are authorized to view for a specified point of view. You can also select the Enterprise Journal's card on the homepage to navigate to the journals list. The journals list provides a central place to manage all active journals that need your attention. You can select the columns to display, sort the list by column, and search for journals. Administrators can publish preferred list views, and you can create and save your own list view. Select columns, sort order, and filtering to set up your preferred list. The journals list displays the journals you have access to, filtered by year, period, and template. You can add and remove additional filters as needed. Administrators create the Enterprise Journals templates, which determine the target where the journals are posted and the journal layout. Journal names should be descriptive to indicate the journal's purpose. Journal ID is a unique identifier for every journal in Enterprise Journals for a year and period. When the journal is posted to the general ledger, this unique ID is posted with it. This provides the ability to track the journal both within Cloud EPM and in the general ledger in the target ERP. When administrators deploy Enterprise Journal templates, they create recurring journals associated with the template for the selected period. Open a recurring journal to enter data. The template determines the layout, including the header and line item attributes. You can enter data manually or import data from CSV files. Enter data into the attributes in the header and add rows as needed to enter data into the line item attributes. A preparer can only delete journal lines if the journal is not posted and the workflow status is with preparer. When you are preparing journals, you can use the swap option to switch debits to credits if you accidentally input the amounts backwards, or if you want to create an offsetting journal to reverse a previously entered journal. You also have the options to print the grid, export to Excel, or delete the grid. When you are finished entering data, save your changes. When you are preparing a journal, you should review any instructions and answer any questions provided by the administrator. You can also add comments and supporting documentation, check the journal properties, view or create alerts, view the approval workflow, and view the audit history. You can run a validation check to identify errors and make any necessary changes before you submit or post the journal. The validation process checks for required fields, matching balances, and proper journal format to ensure that journals will be posted successfully once the approval process is complete. When validation is complete, submit the journal. Notice that the workflow status has changed. Administrators can also specify whether the template can be used for creating ad hoc journals and give permission to users to create them. If you have permission, you can create ad hoc journals using the Create Ad Hoc Journal button. Ad hoc permission allows you to create journals for a year, period, and template, in addition to the recurring journals specified by the administrator in the template. Enter the desired information and save the journal. The journal is added to the list with ad hoc set to yes. If ad hoc is set to no for a template, and you try to create an ad hoc journal, you receive an error message. Now let's sign in as the approver, Carrie Lane. Navigate to the journals list and open the submitted journal. Approvers may approve or reject the journals submitted by the preparer. Note, you can configure the system to allow preparers to post journals without requiring an approval, if that is applicable to your process. Once approved, the system automatically posts the journal. Notice that the workflow status is now set to closed. The Enterprise Journals posting process is based on the workflow process and defined targets. If the target ERP system is Oracle Cloud Financials, Enterprise Journals uses a pre-built direct connector to post to the general ledger. Additionally, you can use a set of provided APIs for direct posting to other ERPs. Lastly, a file-based journal posting option is also available if required. The Enterprise Journals Service Administrator will choose one of these three options for posting the journal to the general ledger. Once you post the journal, the system updates post status and post message, which may include the unique Enterprise Journal ID, a unique batch ID or doc number that the general ledger assigns to identify the posted journal in the ERP, and any messages related to the posting. Alternatively, preparers and approvers can view and work on Enterprise Journals in Microsoft Excel using the Smart View extension. All core actions are available directly in Excel, including creating or deleting ad hoc journals, adding comments and supporting documentation, approving and rejecting journals, and so forth. This allows users to work on their journals entirely in Excel if desired. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.